Welcome. We'll start with class 7 geography, chapter 6, that is natural vegetation and wildlife. Now, when we start with understanding the vegetation and the wildlife, we can classify the vegetation into three broad components, that is the forest, grasslands and shrubs. Now, all these three depend on certain parameters. Now, I can say the vegetation of an arid area, if I visit a desert area, would be very different from region if I visit a grassland or if I visit say mountain top. So all the way you have different vegetations that is seen. Similarly, if I am going up on the mountain, as I move up, there are changes in the vegetation patterns that could be seen, and all those are the various factors that affect the type of vegetation. So I can say if I move up on a mountain, you would have changes in the type of trees that are seen. So towards the top, I would have coniferous forest, that is conical trees that would be seen, and so on. So you have vegetation that varies with height. It also varies with temperature. It varies with moisture, the slope conditions, and the amount of soil or the thickness of soil that is present there. So these are five primary factors that affect the vegetation. Based on these five factors, you have the three categories of vegetation that we talked about. The forest areas are present where you have ample of rainfall and a good temperature that you can see. Grasslands occur in the region of moderate rainfall. And finally, you have shrubs that would occur in the dry areas. We also call these dry areas as arid areas or semi-arid areas, or we also call them as semi-dry areas. So vegetation can broadly be classified as forest, grasslands and shrubs. Now we will understand all of these and their sub-categories one by one. So let's first start with forest. Among the forests, the first type of forest that we will understand is the tropical evergreen forest. Now, understanding the terminology is important here. So once you are clear with the terminology, you won't ever face problems related to understanding the criteria or the classification. Now, when I say you have equator that passes here, you have, let's say, the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn that is passing. Now, the region between equator and the tropics, that is 23.5 degrees north and south, approximately would be the tropical area. So whatever would be covered here, this line is a bit below, it should cross. So all the three lines cross Africa. So that's the best way to understand the various tropics. So all the three lines, that's Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn and equator, would cross the continent of Africa. Now all the region that is 23 degrees north and south of equator would be the tropical region. So whenever I talk about tropical vegetation or tropical forest or tropical climate, I am basically focusing on this region first. Secondly, we will differentiate what is evergreen and what is deciduous. When we talk about evergreen, that means that forest have different type of trees. So let's say there are A, B, C, D, E and F varieties of trees that are present in the forest. Let's say in summer, A, C and E shed their leaves. Those shed their leaves in summers. Now comes the winter, where B and D shed their leaves. And finally in autumn, you have F that sheds their leaves. That means throughout the year, there are some plants that are present on which you have the leaves. So you have leaves here, then you have leaves on these plants, and finally you have leaves on these plants. That means if we consider this throughout the year, all the plants, there would be at least some plants, that some trees that would have leaves on them throughout the year. So throughout the year, if we see it from a distance, we will have a feeling that this tree, this forest is green, and therefore we call them as evergreen forest. That means any time of the year, if you look at that forest, you will feel or you will see that forest remains green, or you have some trees that would have the vegetation or the leaves on them. So that is evergreen. Now a similar terminology which is used instead of evergreen is deciduous. Deciduous means all the trees of that forest shed their leaves in one season. So all the trees shed their leaves mostly say in summers, that is to avoid the dry weather and avoid the process of minimize the process of transpiration. So to reduce transpiration, all of these trees shed their leaves together in summer months. So in the summers or in the autumn months or summer months, if you see those region, you would see those as barren areas without any leaves on them. So that is what is deciduous. Now similar to tropical that we have explained, a similar kind of climatic condition is temperate, but temperate occurs north and south of polar areas. The tropical areas. So north and south of tropical areas you would have the temperate, and that temperate usually lies from 66 degrees and half to 23 degrees and half, and again 66 degrees and half to 23 degrees and half. So that is where you would have the temperate vegetation or the temperate belt. So this is the basic terminology that we have introduced to help you understand the various types of forest. Now let's move on to the first, that is tropical and evergreen. So tropical means occurring in this region, and evergreen means they would have trees leaves throughout the year. They are also known as rainforest. They are commonly seen in the hot and the humid belt, and this hot and humid belt usually occurs near the tropical area where you have rain that occurs throughout the year. Again, since you have this as an evergreen vegetation, the vegetation is so dense that the sunlight, you have trees that are so dense that the sunlight cannot penetrate down. As a result, you do not see sunlight that reaches the lower strata of the vegetation. The common trees that are seen here are rosewood, ebony and mahogany. Now the next is tropical deciduous. Now tropical again occurs in the region of the tropical belt, but they are mainly the monsoon forest area. Now in India you have maximum percentage of land that occurs as a tropical deciduous forest. Usually the monsoon areas are prone to the tropical deciduous vegetation, where during the monsoons you have ample of trees. North Australia, regions of North Australia, the monsoon region of India, the regions of Central America, and kind of regions of the coastal Africa towards the central side are good examples of tropical deciduous forest. As I said, deciduous shed their leaves in summer months to conserve water and to reduce the process of transpiration. Common trees that are seen are sal, teak, neem and shisham. All these are used for making furnitures. Again, the common wildlife that is seen is tigers, lions, elephants and monkeys and langurs. Now next is temperate evergreen. Now this is again evergreen, but this lies in the temperate zone. So eastern margins of southeast USA, you have South China region, you have regions of southeast Brazil that is seen. So all these regions have kind of temperate evergreen forest that is seen here. Usually it occurs on the coastal margins of the mid latitude region. So mid latitude again from 66 and half to 23 and half, and you have them towards the coastal areas. The common vegetation that is seen is oak, pine and eucalyptus. The next is temperate deciduous. Again in the mid latitudinal region they are present, but they are deciduous, that means all of them shed their leaves in one single season. They occur in the northeast margins of United States, regions of New Zealand, then you have Chile, then West Europe region. So all those are the regions where you have temperate deciduous vegetation that is seen. The common trees are oak, ash and beech. Among the wildlife you have deer, fox and wolf that are seen. Among the birds you have pheasants and monals that are commonly seen in temperate deciduous forest. Now in India you have temperate deciduous that occurs in sections of Himalayan region where you have large population of this wildlife that is seen. Now next is Mediterranean vegetation, commonly seen. So this is the Mediterranean Sea. So the region surrounding the Mediterranean Sea, first of all, forms a Mediterranean type of climate. Besides this, you have the region of California, you have the region of Southwest Africa, then you have Southwest Australia and South America, parts of South America that are seen with Mediterranean climate. Now, this climate, you have a typical characteristics that shows you have rains in the winter. So, you have winter rainfall and dry summers. However, the winter rainfall is mild, not very extreme. Mediterranean climate is also known as the orchards of the world. Since you have numerous amount of citrus trees or citrus vegetation that grows here, you have oranges, figs, olives and grapes that are predominantly seen along with lemons. So all the kind of citrus fruits are seen in the Mediterranean belt. They are also present in the east and the northeast margins of the temperate and the deciduous forest. However, they are not seen on the western margins of the deciduous forest. Again, since the region is hot in summers, they have thick barks. The bark of the tree, that's the outermost layer of the tree, is thick, and wax coated leaves are present in order to reduce the transpiration during the summer months, and it's a kind of effort to conserve water for the plants during the summer months. So this is the Mediterranean vegetation. The next is coniferous vegetation. Coniferous vegetation is seen in both in high altitude regions and high latitudinal regions. So as you move up on the globe, latitudinally you would see coniferous vegetation. Also up the mountain you would see coniferous vegetation. So both latitudinal extent and altitude effect. So altitude is height on the mountain, and latitude is as you move up on the higher latitudes, usually around 50 to 70 degrees north and south. You have the coniferous vegetation. This coniferous forests are also known as taiga. Taiga is a Russian word which in Russian means pure or untouched. That means this region is very pure in the sense that you have the scenic beauty that is maintained. Then you have mostly the vegetation is softwood that is seen here. Now this softwood is used for manufacturing of pulp. This pulp is used in paper industry, matchbox and packaging industries. Most common trees that are seen here are cher, pine and cedar. Among the wildlife, you have silver fox, mink and polar bear that are found in the coniferous forest. Next is the tropical grasslands. Now we move on to the next section, that is grasslands. Till now we were focusing on forest. As we classified in the starting, that's forest, grasslands and shrubs. So we completed what is forest. Now we'll move with the grasslands. So grasslands we'll classify under two, the tropical grasslands and the temperate grasslands. Now tropical occur on either side of the equator. So you have the equator and you have the tropical grasslands that are seen on either side of the equator. Low to moderate rainfall is seen. Trees are tall, up to 3 to 4 meters. Now in East Africa, they are known as savannas. Then you have Brazil, where they are known as campos. Then you have Venezuela, where they are known as llanos. So their names in different regions are important for tropical grasslands as well as for temperate grasslands. Common wildlife is elephant, zebra, leopard, deer and giraffe. Now next is temperate grasslands. The grasses are more nutritious in the temperate belt. It occurs, as we said, in the mid-latitudinal region and the interior parts of the continent. The common wildlife is wild buffalo, bison and antelopes. In South America, it is known as pampas. In North America, it is known as prairies. Then you have Central Asia, it's known as steppes. Then you have South Africa, where they are known as velds. In Australia, they are known as dums. So these are the various names of the grasslands that are seen in various parts of the world. So you have prairies, pampas, velds, steppes and downs, which are the common temperate grasslands. Now moving to the next, that is the Next was the shrubs that we classified. Now these shrubs are could be thorny shrubs which occur in the dry areas or the arid areas which are hot. So you have the desert areas. So desert region of Sahara, desert region of Thar in India, the Arabian desert in central the South Arabian region. So all these are examples of thorny bushes where you have scarce vegetation, very less rainfall. Most of the trees occurs in the form of cactus, where stem is modified to leaf and leaf is modified to thorns, and this is again to reduce the process of transpiration or water loss from the trees. They usually occur on the western margins of the continent. So this is the thorny bush. Again, you have the extreme areas, the tundra regions, the north polar regions and the south regions of the Antarctica, where you have a kind of very less trees that are seen. Most of the trees are in form of mosses of lichens that are seen, or rhododendrons. Now most common animals that are seen here are Arctic owl, polar bear, snow leopard, snow fox. Then you have seals, walrus and penguins that are seen. The animals have thick fur and skin to protect them from the cold temperature. So this is what is the tundra climate. With this we covered the chapter 6 of class 7. We'll be covering the next chapters in the next lessons. You can subscribe to our channel for more updates, and for doubts you can leave those as comments. Have a good day.